I'm Leah, and this is my meet cute.
Falling in love is funny. It's weird, awkward, happy, or sad. It's a vibe. Where if you know, you know. Or do you? More than anything, it's personal and all around us. Inspired by true events and performed by real actors, Meet Cute presents When I Met You.
I guess it feels like there's something that inhabits people when they talk to you about the Gila. People who know the Gila and spend time there. They sort of get this misty-eyed quality about them. It's like they can't find the words. I think that's just the representation of something of the indescribable quality of the place. Maybe wild is the term that would almost inevitably come up in people's descriptions of why it's so special to them. Yeah, wild is the word. As someone who grew up in New Mexico and who feels very close to this landscape in the Southwest, and having never gone to the Gila for the first 36 years of my life, it held a certain mystique, for sure. Feels like my whole relationship to the Gila was prefaced by this expanse of time of just encountering people speaking about the Gila in this way, full of deep reverence, left me very intrigued. Typically, when people refer to the Gila, they're referring to the Gila National Forest, which is roughly 3 million acres in southwest New Mexico. It includes 2 wilderness areas and 3 watersheds. It's the 6th largest national forest in the continental United States. Yeah, there was definitely one distinct moment where I feel like I was suddenly embodying and surrounded by that wildness. But it was prefaced by the 6-hour drive to the Gila, which was long on dirt roads, very windy. You're like driving on a crazy forest road for 44 miles deep into the heart of the national forest through the plains of St. Augustine, like this wild, fully enclosed, ancient lake basin, kind of like a prairie. And then up into the mountains, out into the grasslands, then back into the forest. You are immersed into it. My very first trip there was like this crazy drive. I was like, wow, it's this big, wild country, just like everyone said. And we arrived on the first flank of Bear Wallow Mountain, kind of on the north side of the National Forest, above Negrita Drainage. We parked, we're getting ready for dinner, and then literally within 5 minutes of us being there, we hear a series of yips, and we turn around, and there are 3 Mexican gray wolves, maybe 50 yards from where we were standing. They trotted right by our campsite. It was so magical. I was completely blown away, beyond words. I just kind of stood there feeling very small and very grateful for that little glimpse of these wild, beautiful creatures. The wolves are one of the most extraordinary things about the Gila. There's been a reintroduction program there since 1998. They nearly went extinct, and now there are fewer than 190. They're still very much in peril, but also beautiful, a living representation of wild country. The lobo embodies that in so many ways. I endeavor to spend about 25% of my time there, more or less 5 to 7 days out of every month. Since that first trip, I've been an additional 10 or 12 times. It's like the scope and scale of that place and the wildness of that country. I try to visit a new spot every time I go down there. You can either come in from the north or drive all the way down to Silver City and up Highway 15 to the heart of the wilderness and hike in from there. I've done some trail work there, lots of camping. One time a couple of mountain lions came and visited the camp, which seemed like a casual experience to everyone there. I found it to be pretty uncomfortable. I think it's just been this sense of getting to know a place, getting to know a whole landscape, and Of course, that includes the human communities who live within and beside it. But also the more than human community. You know, this rich, biodiverse, ecological habitat that's incredibly varied and super unique. It's just a wild thing to spend time thinking about. Relationship to place and how we come to know it, how it comes to feel familiar, and what that means for us as human beings, and then to sort of advocate on behalf of the land. How it's been? It's been wild. It's just been wild. Hi, I'm Leia, and this is my Meet Cute.